Okay. What do you think? Imagine you live in a country where your ethnic or religious group persecutes another group. You know that you could be arrested, threatened, or harmed, perhaps even killed for helping someone from that group. One day you see a child from the other group hiding in the woods. The child is bleeding and unable to walk. What do you do? A. Inform authorities about the child. B. Bring water, food, and bandages to the child once he gets dark. C. Take the child to your house for bandages and food, but then make her leave. D. Hide the child in your home, risking jail time or even death for you and your family. Or E. Do nothing and try to forget what you saw. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "He who accepts evil without protesting against it is really cooperating with it." It's a free for the whole month of February. The whole month of February, the National Center of Human and Civil Rights, Civil and Human Rights, sorry, is free thanks to the Coca-Cola Foundation. And this is my first time coming here, and it's been here since, I want to say 2014. And what's ironic about it is that in college, I actually did some public relations work for the museum and still haven't been up here, so I'm excited. Isn't that right, darling? What'd you say? Uh-huh. And of course the line is so long. Thank you. She gotta do a delivery at 1:40. Huh? Yeah, it's all right though. We'll get it next time. Let me call her. Hey, what you doing? Oh, my tickets. You can put it back in the camera.
Thank you. perspective that they had.
Thank you. violent tactics, they face the uncertainties of their journey with optimism.
There is a possibility we will not be served at some stop. There is a possibility we might be arrested. This is the only problem that I anticipate.
An incident at Rock Hill, South Carolina provided a frightening preview of what was to come. Three of the riders were attacked and beaten as they tried to enter a whites-only waiting room. Sunday, Mother's Day, further violence exploded just outside of Anniston, Alabama.
In Anniston, we were surrounded by a mob who battled us out of Anniston for about 4 miles until one of our tires went flat. At that point, they started breaking into the windows of the bus with chains and pipes and one thing and another. They finally threw a bomb into the bus.
Immediate flash fire into the bus. And I tried to open the door. The only thing I could hear is, let's burn them niggas. Let's burn them niggas alive. At that moment, fuel tank exploded, and they ran, and that was the only way we could get that door open. A man came up to me, and I'm coughing and strangling. He said, boy, you all right? And I nodded my head, and the next thing I knew, I was on the ground. He had hit me with a part of a baseball bat. And this is when I see the highway patrolman. He pulls his gun and he fired in the air. He says, okay, you've had your fire. Let's move back. And that's what stopped it.
Unaware of this attack, the second bus continued on to Birmingham.
Last night, a man phoned me, said he was close to the leaders of the Ku Klux Klan. He said he wanted to give me a tip. Be sure and be at the bus terminal on Sunday, he said, because you're going to see action.
James Peck and I, we were scheduled to test the facilities. So he looked at me and I looked at him and we proceeded to go into the terminal.
They took them into corridors and alleys and began beating them, began hitting them with lead pipes and with key rings and with their fists. They knocked one man, a white man, down at my feet, and they beat him and kicked him until his face was a bloody red pulp. The police did not arrive at this scene until 10 minutes late, when these men had, as if on signal, dispersed and had gone further down the street, where I saw some of them discussing their achievement of the day right under the windows of the police commissioner's office.
Now, I hope that these agitators outside of this state who are seeking to come here to stay at home and mind their own business.
If men like Governor Patterson and Governor Barnett of Mississippi and also Governor Davis of Louisiana would carry out the good oath of their office, then citizens would be able to travel in this country, and then people in Tel Aviv and Moscow and London would not pick up their newspaper for breakfast and realize that America is not living into the dream with liberty and justice for all.
The Freedom Riders were marooned in Birmingham after bus drivers refused to transport them any further.
I had very mixed feelings. I'd learned to be afraid overnight. I was no longer this fearless rider. I was no longer so interested in dying for the cause. I appreciated being alive.
Hurried negotiations between Birmingham officials, Attorney General Robert Kennedy, and his on-the-scene representative John Siegenthaler, arranged for the riders to continue to New Orleans by plane. But any thoughts by Kennedy or Birmingham that the Freedom Rides might end was short-lived. 3 days later, a new group of students from colleges in Nashville arrived at Birmingham. After failing to secure bus passage to Montgomery, they were arrested by Police Commissioner Bull Connor and driven back to the Tennessee border late Thursday night. They vowed they would return, and within a day, they did. Governor Patterson assured John Siegenthaler that Alabama's Highway Patrol would protect the Freedom Riders, but Governor Patterson's promises soon proved illusory. When the buses arrived in Montgomery, they were met by a mob. Before police could break up the crowd, at least 20 people had been beaten and injured.
One of the riders, a white student, was banged up pretty badly. Two other students were hurt. And in trying to rescue a white girl member of the group, an aide to Attorney General Robert Kennedy, John Siegenthaler, was knocked out.
The next day, Reverend Martin Luther King Jr., Reverend Fred Shuttlesworth, and James Farmer, the National Director of Corps, arrived in Montgomery for an evening service honoring the Freedom Riders. Gathered in the First Baptist Church, over 1,500 supporters were soon surrounded by a mob of 3,000 who bombarded the building with rocks and bottles and burned cars. Reverend King was on the telephone with Robert Kennedy, entreating him to take action to protect those in the church. Kennedy was simultaneously urging Governor Patterson to disperse the mob.
In this situation, I want to make this announcement that the city is now under martial law and troops are on the way into Montgomery.
The violence was quelled, and under pressure from Washington, the governors of Alabama and Mississippi both agreed to have state police and the National Guard protect the Freedom Riders. On Wednesday morning, May 24th, state police and National Guardsmen escorted a dozen Freedom Riders from Montgomery to Jackson, Mississippi.
Much of anything but fire hose, because it's just water, but I mean, it's crazy pressure on us. Like that. But that was so good.
Section of our program to a halt and ask you to assemble in your respective groups and begin the march for freedom now. Let us begin quietly and orderly to move out. We'll see you at the Lincoln Memorial.
Evening News with Walter Cronkite.
Good evening.
Dr. Martin Luther King, the apostle of nonviolence in the civil rights movement, has been shot to death in Memphis, Tennessee.
I have some very sad news for all of you.
Dr. King was standing on the balcony of the second floor hotel room tonight when, according to a companion, shot was fired.
That was nice in there. Like all the clothes that had Colin Kaepernick in there too.
and you want me to go somewhere and fight, but you won't even stand up for me here at home.
What are your religious dictates?
We
believe that we should take part in no wars and take the lives of human beings. It's just one of the religious dictates.
So I found my entire life not wearing a headscarf, and then I applied for my first job wearing it, and then getting this reaction, like I'm not welcome. I felt like my
Hi, my name is Ruzbeh from Iran.
Hi.
I used internet and blogging to bypass censorship in Iran, which is usual things for us, for a country like us. A lot of red lines, a lot of pressure from government, and internet is for me, and blog was for me a way to
bypass. And that became our theater. You know, we spoke about things that we were familiar with, which is harassment. You know, we had the cops who come in every weekend.
We recognize that there are